with one of the most frustrating maps I ever played on this mantle. Now, I hope they change the format of the maps a little bit, because if this is how the end game looks like, I won't like it. So first of all, the desert is about 65 degrees hot over here, and it's actually way above your normal limit. And also, over here there are so many elite zombies that you'll kind of get smashed a lot. And we can't open this door, we need a key for it. I searched everywhere, I couldn't find it. Fishes, tombs, campfires over here. That doesn't really matter. Campfire and the farm. So to get over here, you need to go to the train station over here in the Sunburnt Desert. And after we fix the train, I have another video on that, you just go over here. Remember to lower the bridge, otherwise you will not be able to access it from the other part. I'm not sure what happens if you die while doing this, because it seems like over here is the bridge that you have to lower in order to access from the northern part of Solaris. I'm not sure what happens if you die, if you save at the campfire, and if you die over there. Well, I guess technically you just walk over here, but that's such a long walk. That's a marathon of running to get over here to the station. So, let me show you the recipe for the steakhouse. I mean, it's kind of like a little sneak peek, but if you don't want to look, just put the hands above your eyes. Steakhouse. Salad. So this is what it requires, it increases your heat protection by 5 degrees. I mean, it's not much, you'll still get sunburn in certain areas, but it's more than enough. Also, it's pretty funny because the storyline is something like people demanded more salads because the chef only cooked meat in the military base, and he then added the steakhouse salad, which has a lot of meat again. A little funny, it was over here somewhere. Other than that, I completely cleared this area. You need to come behind the base, something like this. Yeah, something like this. And there are also a lot of turrets over here. And you also need to destroy, kill the enemies from here and the turrets, and then the enemies over there as well, in order to open the main gates to the base. Otherwise, you'll have a very, very hard time. To be honest, I didn't like that because I died probably, what, 20 times, and it was something like 2 hours of work. Solaris Train Station, that might help with the heat. Like what? Really, what's this quest about? Okay, I guess we just have to search the boxes, and I already searched the boxes, but I didn't see anything. Okay, I'll not destroy it if the game doesn't let me. So that is strange station. Well, I guess we can search the boxes, and if the boxes don't have it, we can... Oh, it's over there. Self-heating water bottles. Self-heating water bottles, well... Yeah, I don't need that right now. I guess it'll be in the other storage room. Four hats. Nope, still not going to help me pull off. It might be a new item. Okay, so there's nothing over here. Okay, there's nothing over there, so it has to be over here. Cold and classy desert helmet. Confirmation of delivery to the desert farm. Oh. Okay, that's still not really in my way, but we'll go over there. I mean, I love the game and the full release is coming, but if they just put a lot of elite enemies with a lot of turrets in a very small space and then they make you go over it, it's kind of weird. Also, this is the first time I was forced to use healing items. I never used healing items in the game, well, maybe in the first episodes, but other than that, if you check all of the videos, I never had any healing items with me. I mean, that was kind of like a personal thing. Don't use healing items because they make the game too easy. Oh, it's a baby deer. But nope. I had to use the healing item. So where are we going? Over there. So this is the train we arrived on. Come on, don't leave me enjoy my onion alone. Quite a nice train. I mean, the trains are very nice in the game, and I hope they make it a permanent addition to the game, so you could ride the trains all over the place. That's just a wishing well. To be honest, there are not a lot of materials in this area. You're basically going to get junk items and a few steel bits. Map is super dangerous because of these things. Look at that, 46 degrees. Yeah, you can't cancel the animation, which is the bad part. I don't want to fight them. It's so silly that they follow you all around the place. Eventually they'll give up, but it's still annoying. And this was my life for about 2 hours. And I'm also still playing with the ring, I mean with the digital watch. I refuse to take it off, it's way too good. I mean, this would have taken me 3 hours if I didn't have the watch with me. But I suppose we have to rest here for safety. That was so weird. It almost felt like cheating. Okay, I see it, I see it. Okay, I should have cleared this area as well, but you know, when you have a quest, it actually shows the quest item. When I first cleared this place, didn't have one. Not a bit lazy. Let's just take the easy side. So how do you get inside if you don't have that? No idea how you get inside if you don't have this thing. Hey, more salad. I love salads, especially in this game. Mailbox for the response for the desert helmet thing. Okay, guess that's another clue. Well, let's open the door because you don't want to use the... Okay, I was joking about that. I don't always want to come over here using brute force. Now, the mailbox, I hope is not destroyed. I mean, I don't remember destroying it. Should be in front of the house. Oh no, it's not in front of the house. Then it must be near the road. Ah, dog house, nice. Okay, I don't see the mailbox anywhere. Huh. So it's not at the entrance, it's not at the front entrance. Okay, let's look all over the farm. I mean, it might be in a weird position. I don't remember destroying it, like I said. Also, this is jungle, so yeah, don't really go there if you don't have to do. you don't have to go over there. Where's that mailbox? I searched everywhere almost. Maybe on this side of the train tracks? No. Let's check the overhead map. I mean, sometimes it will show up on the map, which is a lot easier than just searching all over the place. Maybe it's over there. Okay. Or maybe I'm just not seeing it because the heat has gone to my brain. Oh, that's only the sign. Come on, game. This should have been the mailbox 10 times already. So it was not over there. Must be on this side. No? Like I said, I don't remember destroying it, and usually they don't let you destroy quest items. Very weird. I guess we'll just have to search for it better. Or maybe it was hidden over here near the house? No, it's not. Okay, this is weird. Usually you don't have problems fighting items, but now this is kind of... There are not a lot of quests in the area as well, so... Nope, nothing over here. I mean, they barricaded all the entrances. Why did they have sandbags on this room? Well, I guess this room was for storage only. Nope, nothing in here. I mean, I'll continue to destroy the house until I find the mailbox. Okay, I have nothing to say about this, it's weird. Well, maybe except that I hate the game sometimes, because I went through all of this work just to not find the mailbox. So it's not near the barn either. It's not on the side either. Not near the barrels. It should have a quest marker. If it's a quest location, it should have a quest marker, so I assume it will be easy to see. Check out the mailbox. I will check it out if I can see it. Oh, not to the fishing pole. And this is why I have healing items on this map. It's very rare that I use them. Maybe it's somewhere around here? No, nothing around here either. Okay, so I basically cleared every part of the enclosure. Huh. Okay, let's run side by side of the wall. Maybe it's really hidden somewhere. I mean, the wall is actually a small fence, but okay. Well, at least we're farming resources. I mean, it was only 2 hours to clear the area and see what's here. I don't think it will be on the other side of the road, but we'll have to check there as well. Wait, is that a mailbox? What? Why? Why would the mailbox be there? Well, because I have to kill this guy. So this is the road to Island's farm, but over there it's okay, let's not think about it. He's not interested in helmet and in your helmet designs. Earth forces. Military road checkpoint and you can get it back from there. Oh wow, that was super annoying. I basically wasted a lot of time just searching for the mailbox. Yeah. Okay, it's in the truck. Oh, that's interesting. Protects against sweltering heat. Oh, it also has the damage block. Okay, so to survive in the desert, you need a steakhouse salad recipe, and then you also need this weird helmet. Okay, that one's so bad. Also, we need to recover the another fuel cell. And this is weird, because actually the mech is not operational. So you might be able to retrieve the the third battery without actually fighting the mech, although I suspect it will be something weird as well. Desert helmet. Come on, the desert helmet is not in the game, that's so silly. Must be an oversight from the developers. They haven't finished adding everything in the map over here. They said they wanted to add the arc as well. Probably this is the arc? I have no idea. Let's go and get that battery and then I'll search it for it a little longer. Then probably I'll end the video if I can't find anything about the key. Okay, so this place was actually filled with silly turrets like this one. Now to destroy the turrets you... Well, I guess you can always throw grenades at them, or you can just get behind them, because the rocket turrets don't do as much damage as the bullet turrets. That's cheating, the other turrets didn't turn on me like that. Oh man. You hate this map so much. That's how it looks inside of the base. Not very welcoming. What was that weird sound? I guess this is the blind spot for the turrets. What did I do that? I thought you couldn't do a charged power attack with a sledgehammer. Oh, I guess you can. By the way, they're not attacking any humans because I think they said something about them being designed not to attack the personnel of the base. And technically, the zombies are the personnel of the base, so that's why they don't attack them, because they are part of the army base. Which is funny in a way, but pretty logical. But I guess it's a little harder without that helmet. But can't complain too much about it. Okay, let's try and get... Okay, looks like the mech wants to fight me, even though it should have... whatever. Ouchie. Yeah, this is why I hate the map. I hate it so much because it... imagine playing all of this, I mean, I could... not use the watch, but it would be the same thing. I mean, I could run straight to the other campfire. Okay, change of plan, we'll do something else. Yeah, go away, I'm busy. Oh, there is still a turret to left over there. I have to destroy it when I remember. Okay, let's clear the surrounding area for the combat. And we'll put a lot of mines near the mech, so that will actually help us win the fight. I'm not sure, I guess the pills are faster to swallow and you'll get some HP regen back. It actually blows up. Okay. This boss fight is not going according to plan. I mean, I could, you know, stop the video and just redo everything or edit it, but that's not my style anyway. Okay, so let's heal up, because the heat is also annoying. Yeah, it's annoying, but as you can see, I'm wearing full warm gear on me. I guess you already intended to fight with the cold. Okay, so this beautiful machine is called the Crown. Wait, I guess we can try to use the rifle, but I don't think it's loaded. Okay, that didn't work. I mean, it worked halfway. Can I upgrade my rifle more than this? I could also try to use the shield, but I'm not sure how it works. Okay, so mines and then... Oh yeah, let's also take the pills with us. Can we upgrade the pills more than this? I'm not sure. But this is definitely one of the hardest fights. No, hardest fights. The other guys are complete pushovers. Maybe I want to use the sledgehammer on this thing because it might be resistant to that damage. Actually, let's see how this works because I never really tested it. No, I don't think it will work too well. But I'll just keep it. So it automatically blocks the damage. I'm pretty sure I'll pull the Stalker. Okay, so no zombies can disturb our little fight. Yeah, let's take the resources back. What? That's it? Just 10? Okay, that's too weak to actually use in battle. Okay, sorry about this. We're resetting again. I'm just trying out some options. So, kind of like this would be the best setup. I don't think it will be cooler during the night time. But we'll just have to see. I mean, I could sleep for extra HP, but... no. We could also try to fight the mech on the cooler area of the map. So before we start the fight, where is... Okay, I guess you have to sit over here. Yeah, desert helmet is... It's far away. It's probably a few days away. Okay, this is not a really fun mechanic. It sounds like he's throwing stones at something. That does a lot more damage to him. Yeah. Okay, I'll not get close to him during his phase. I mean, he can't attack us, so we're safe over here. Safe-ish. Also, don't want to go too far away because we might reset him. Well, that was pretty painful. I mean, I guess you can safely kill him if you drag him down the... You can safely kill him if you take him down the line over here. I believe in the developers. I don't think if you die after you kill him, you are dead. Oh, we have the fuel cell. Thank you, game. That was actually not so bad, but I guess if you're not prepared, this will destroy you. Yeah, these things could have been so helpful against the zombies, but nope. We don't use them against the zombies, we use them against the player. Besides, we don't even know what our mission is yet. I mean, are we supposed to save the island or just survive? And remember, we have to take the power cell back to the island. To the evacuation site. Because that's where it will be needed. I mean, you don't want to lose this stupid... You don't want to lose a permanent inventory slot like this. Okay, let's try to make a run for it, but it will be painful. Okay, let's not make a run for it then. But there are so many enemies, I don't want to fight all of them. Okay, they just leave me alone. They just leave me alone. Okay, so this is the place where you are supposed to deliver the power source. Haven't been here for a while. Vroom, vroom. Now we just need one more and we'll be done with it. I guess the whole map is a good design, but just look at how big it is. The desert and over here. This is basically the biggest map. I mean, it occupies such a big portion of the map, this region over here, the desert, but it doesn't really have anything on it, and I explored so much of it, I mean every bit of it, and I couldn't do anything about it. And over here, like I said, we need a key. You can enter through here, go all the way over there, and then boom, you need a key. Probably in the next update, I don't know, we'll just have to see. But for now, let's end the video right over here. Bye.